How are you? I'm glad to see you. We're going to have tea with Junior Ray again. He's not here, but he'll show up shortly.
Hey, Pritchard.
Hey, girls. Good to see you. Good to see you. Those are some of the neighborhood girls. They work down at the MPCC, which, as you know, is the Magic Pussy Cabaret and Club. If you've read the Yazoo Blues, which is the second book of Junior Ray's adventures, you'll know all about that. It was the place that he thought was perhaps the most wonderful place in all the world, in what he called Mephis, M-E-F-F-I-S. And Mephis, M-E-F-F-I-S, compared to New Orleans, Mephis was Babylon. So Junior Ray has had a lot to say about the MPCC, the Magic Pussy Cabaret and Club in the Yazoo Blues. You probably want to look it up. There's some things I need to clear up before he gets here, and they're important things. I think that I have a sort of missionary zeal about it, but it's about the Delta. Now, look, this is Mississippi. The Delta, the Mississippi Delta, the place that my character Junior Ray lives in and has his bumbling adventures in, is not down near the Gulf of Mexico. It's not the delta of the Mississippi River as it empties into the Gulf of Mexico. It is an alluvial plain in this part of Mississippi. All of this in Mississippi, all this, this, and this, are what are known as the hills. There are other sections that have, but they're all the hills. The delta is very distinct. It's distinct in elevation. It was distinct in its economy. It was distinct in its cultural habits, or lack thereof. Here's the delta we're talking about. It starts up here near the Tennessee state line, and Highway 61 opens up into this depression. You have the river and the levee going out this way to define it on the west, and it comes in at Vicksburg, and then this oval is defined on the east by the Lus Hills, the bluffs that come down like this, and it goes down, and then the Yazoo River system, and it all comes out, and it comes together again, and the Yazoo River goes out into the Mississippi at Vicksburg. It's an oval. It's about 200 miles long. Its width at its greatest, somewhere right in here, is about 67 miles. Its elevation is different. Elevation all around here is 300 and something feet, 300, 335, 350 feet above sea level. And the delta begins at about 199 above sea level and goes down to only about 91 feet above sea level by the time it gets down here to Pantherburn. The delta is very strange. It was a swamp. It was as exotic as Luzon. It was as exotic as Brazil back there before it was, shall we say, developed. I don't know whether developed or ruined is the right term. This oval that I just showed you, that is the Mississippi Delta or the Yazoo Basin, was at one time the largest stand of hardwood timber in the world. It's also the place that Faulkner calls the Big Woods in his story, The Bear. Now Faulkner, of course, lived over here in Lafayette County. It looks Lafayette County, but they say Lafayette County over in Oxford. It's not in the Delta. But this Delta, when Faulkner was a boy and before, listen, this delta over here was a kind of broadleaf swamp. It was vast, it was dark, it was filled with bear, it was filled with bobcat and panther, and alligators. So in fact, some of the biggest alligators in the state of Mississippi still live in it. Now, of course, a lot of the delta looks like Kansas because agriculture has wiped away all the, a lot of, not all, but a lot of the sloughs and a lot of the woods. The history of the Delta is sort of like the history of Ireland. It's more mythology and tall tale telling. On the other hand, its mythology and tall tale telling is its history. The Delta is not scenic, but it's haunting, if it is anything. Attitudes were very strange there. You could even right up into modern times, your wife could shoot you and burn your body. And the judge would just say, well, we'll consider that justifiable homicide. If you had shot at the sheriff when he came to investigate that, they'd say, but we can't have you shooting at the law, and they would send you to prison. My mother's father shot and killed Percy Houston there on the streets of Tunica, Mississippi. Not long after that, his daughter Una Mae shot him. He didn't die from the wound, and she would have shot him twice, but her husband grabbed her arm. None of it ever went to trial, not one single bit of it. And there's story after story after story about that. So you get the idea that there is an underlying violence in the Delta, and there is, which is why, you know, Junior Ray, my character, lovable as I think he is, keeps a .38 in his pocket. Junior Ray's people came from over around in here in the Mississippi Hills, and they, over in the 20s and 30s, filtered down and came down out of the bluffs into the Delta and became sharecroppers over here for large landed planters in the Delta. Well, they mostly settled on the eastern side of the Delta. The labor for the plantations in most of the Delta was black. After the Civil War, the planters, so much of the black population was going north. It was one of the times of the Great Exodus. The planters brought in Cantonese, Chinese, Southern Chinese contract labor. By the 1880s, the Cantonese were right in the middle of the Delta. Most, at that time, worked out their contract and went back to China, but others set up a little business, a grocery store. So the Delta had a population of Cantonese that spoke Cantonese, in fact, and indeed they called us the Bak Gwei, which is, of course, the white devils, and I'm sure we were. And then they called the black population, they called them Hak Gwei, black devils, which they weren't. Before the rights movement changed everything, the Chinese had, by that time, integrated into the white school system, and that was past history. Whites and blacks have made their peace with each other, and life goes on. In fact, I would say, you know, to those who say that there have been no changes, listen, there have been massive changes over in here, and massive changes in here. And changes are still going on. For instance, the political power is, in many of the Delta counties, coming into the hands of the black population, which hadn't had it since the 1860s and 70s, during the time of Reconstruction. But life goes on, and things are going to do well. I don't know that there'll be huge progress, but the Delta will retain much of its character for a long, long time, I think. There's much good to be said about the Delta, and indeed there's much that is not good about the Delta. But I would say overall, there's a sort of general improvement.
Hey, son of a bitch.
Back at you, Junior Ray.